رباه عفوك إني للنور مدت يداي نزعت أسرار قلبي وجئت ألقي أسايا.
إن الحمد لله نسأله ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونتوب لله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أعوذ بالله تعالى وإياكم منها. ثم أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. All those who believe in Allah, fear Allah as he should be feared, and die not except in a state of Islam. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in the Quran, والله يخلق ما يشاء ويختار. Allah creates everything and he chooses among his creation. As Allah سبحانه وتعالى has chosen four sacred months out of 12 to be the months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and today we have the last Jum'ah of one of these months, which is the month of Rajab. As you know, there are four months, sacred months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned them in the Quran, and even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned a lot of benefits of these four beautiful sacred months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the unique things about this month, that every good deed you do is multiplied, but also the sins are greater than any other time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he chosen these 4 months, he chose the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam among mankind to be the rahmatan lil alameen, to be the mercy of everyone and everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen too one day to be the best day of the whole week long, which is the day of Jum'ah. And all of you are witnessing that day. And also Allah has chosen among all the places on earth, the most beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the masajid. And you are doing that right now, answering the call of love in the most beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with doing the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the khutbah today is about love and the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before I start, I want just to give you a little bit of hint, what is the meaning of love? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an incident, like was one of the battle, and he saw a lady. That lady was searching for her kid, for her baby. And when she found him, she grabbed him and she put him on his stomach and she started to breastfeed him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always used every incident to give the companions around him a lesson, a life lesson. So he looked at the companions around him and he told them, أَتَرَوْنَ هَذِهِ الْمَرْأَةَ بِطَارِحَةً بِوَلَدِهَا فِي النَّارِ. Do you see this lady is going to throw her kid in fire? Usually the answer of the companion, Allah wa Rasuluhu A'lam, Allah and his Prophet knows best. But in that incident and in that situation, they said, La wallahi, no, by Allah, no way this lady, we see her, and even they described she was hugging the baby in the way, protecting him in every way. So if even something to hit her, not the baby. They were in a battle. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at the companions and he smiled and he said, لَاللَّهُ أَرْحَمُ بِكُمْ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْمَرْأَةِ عَلَى وَلَدِهَا. Indeed, Allah is more than this mother to her baby. Allahu Akbar. This is to show us a small example. This is to show us a small example of love. This is the love of human to human, mother to her baby. Can you imagine the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you? And I will give you one ayah will change a lot of things in your life, inshallah, and you will increase your love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today, inshallah. Because the meaning of love, you cannot say you love someone without knowing more about him, yes? So if you want to increase your love to someone, there is some characteristics of love, qualities of love. Okay, either a look or good behavior or good manners or showing mercy and all of these things. So how can we increase our love to Allah throughout the Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about him in the Quran. So I will mention to you that ayah in Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number 53. And I'm telling you the number of the ayah because it has a beautiful meaning. If you want to look for more inshallah meaning after the khutbah inshallah. Ayah number 53 in Surah Az-Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is talking to him and he's giving him command. And that command is a unique command in the whole entire Quran. That even the scholars and the interpreters of the Quran, they said, there is no a single ayah anywhere else, not even in the Quran or any books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, talking about these two names and attribution of Allah like this ayah. So what is this ayah? I want you to listen to it, not only by your ears, by your heart too, inshallah. Allah is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
Allah is telling the Prophet, say ya Muhammad, قل يا عبادي to my servants. And the word abd in the Quran is an honor word. So when you hear the word abd in the Quran, you will find followed by a name of a prophet or describing the prophet without even any name. Because this is an honor word. Even higher than the word prophet. Even higher than the word messenger, Rasul and Nabi. For example, when Allah wants to teach the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about any previous prophet, he will tell him, wazkur rasuluna, wazkur nabiyuna. No, he will say what? Wazkur abadana. Because he wants to teach him about that, the most beautiful thing about these prophets. So he will tell him, for example, about Dawood. وَذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا دَاوُودَ ذَا الْأَيْدِ إِنَّهُ أَوَّابَ. Remember my servant Dawood. So he used the word abd. And when he wants to teach him about patience, he used the word abd. Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam.
وَذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا أَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ بِنُصْبٍ وَعَذَابٍ.
Remember my servant Ayyub alayhi salam. We want to teach the Prophet about patience. And even in the plural form, the word ibad mentioned also, وَذْكُرْ عِبَادَنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ أُولِي الْأَيْدِي وَالْأَبْصَارِ. So the word abd is an honor word. And even Allah has honored the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the journey of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, the greatest journey ever to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In some narrations he mentioned was in the month of Rajab, which is in the month we have right now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the first chapter, in the first verse of Surah al-Isra, honor the Prophet with the word abd.
سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهِ.
So here Allah has honored the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that great journey from Mecca to Al-Aqsa to lead all the prophets there and from Al-Aqsa to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah has described him with the word abd. And the last but not the least, for the word abd, Allah has honored the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by receiving our manual and our GPS to Jannah, the Quran. In that chapter you are reading every Friday, the first verse of Surah Al-Kahf. What is the first verse?
Alhamdulillahi الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا.
All praise be to Allah, the one who sent to his servant the book. And here that means the Quran. Do you understand the meaning of abd? So the best interpretation of the Quran is from the Quran itself. Okay? So that's the reason I want you to go back to the ayah. In Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number 53, Allah is telling the Prophet, say ya Muhammad, to who? To my servants, ibadi. So when you hear the word ibad, you expect to hear a name of prophets or describing one of the prophets. But in this ayah, he's saying different thing completely. He's saying, say ya Muhammad, to my servants, those who are committing sins excessively. How come? How come those who are committing sins excessively come after that honored word? And that word was describing all the prophets with it. The answer is, when those who are committing sins excessively goes back to Allah, and they know the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah, and they repent to Allah, they reach to that level of the prophets. Allahu Akbar. Talking to who? Never give up on the mercy of Allah. He's saying, tell ya Muhammad, my servants, those who are committing sins excessively. Number one, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Never give up of the mercy of Allah. Some people, the shaitan, one of the traps of the shaitan is to remind you with your sins. And to make you give up of asking Allah forgiveness of that sins. But Allah is giving you comfort in this ayah and telling you, never give up of the mercy of Allah. And to give you more comfort, some people will say, what's about major sins? Allah give you the comfort in the following, followed by two emphases in this ayah, to show the love of Allah to us. Number one, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Indeed, Allah forgives all sins and mistakes. Allahu Akbar. Allah didn't say, indeed, Allah forgives the sins. No, He said, all sins and mistakes, جَمِيعًا. So whenever you ask Allah forgiveness with sincerity and repentance with sincerity, Allah is promising you to forgive all of your sins and mistakes. And followed by another emphasis, beautiful one. The only reason for us to enter Jannah is the coming one. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Indeed, He's all forgiving and all merciful. For forgiving, one of the companions came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the day of Arafah, the most important day of Hajj, the day that Allah is returning His people back as they are newly born from all sins and mistakes. All of their sins and mistakes is erased. So he came to the Prophet to ask him, who would be among us doing the great sin? Who would be doing a great sin in that position, standing in the day of Arafah? So the Prophet answered him and he told him, the one who asks Allah forgiveness and he doubt that Allah forgive him or not. This is the one who is doing the major sin. You will tell me how? Because when you are doubting the mercy of Allah, as you are doubting the names and the attribution of Allah, and this is by itself is a great sin, is a major sin. Allah promised you full forgiveness. Allah promised those who are doing Hajj, ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة. The only reward for them is Jannah. How come you doubt that Allah forgive you or not? And you are standing before Allah. So he said, the one who asks Allah forgiveness and he doubts that Allah forgive him or not, this is the one who is making a major sin on that day. So we shouldn't be doubting the forgiveness of Allah, because Allah said, إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. For الرَّحِيمُ, the last word of the ayah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, without this word, no one will enter Jannah. He said, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةُ أَحَدٌ بِعَمَلِهِ. No one will enter Jannah because of their good deeds. So the companion answered the Prophet, even you, ya Rasulullah, you will not enter Jannah because of your good deeds? He said, even me, except if Allah covered me and showered me by His mercy. And Allah is giving us that hope in this ayah. He's all forgiving and all merciful. And we have to believe in that and to see the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. And that's the reason all of you are doing right now the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, What is the most beloved deeds to Allah? أحب الأعمال إلى الله. He said, الصلاة على وقتها. Performing the prayer on its time. And all of you right now are performing the prayer in the most beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and even in a unique way in the day of Allah, the day of Jum'ah. In addition to that, Rajab too, which is the last Jum'ah of Rajab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of your good deeds and inshallah forgive all of our sins and mistakes. Say Ameen. So the prayer is the most beloved deeds to Allah, and the Prophet mentioned something beautiful about it. He said, As-salatu ila as-salah, والجمعة إلى الجمعة، ورمضان إلى رمضان، والعمرة إلى العمرة، كفارة لما بينهما. From the prayer to the other prayer, from جمعة to the other جمعة, from رمضان to other رمضان, and from عمرة to other عمرة, what is between is forgiven. So you are sitting, all of you right now, from last جمعة, Allah is sending you angels, making dua for you, asking Allah forgiveness for you from last Jum'ah to this Jum'ah. So when you are getting out of that door, you are forgiven from last Jum'ah to this Jum'ah. Do you see the proof of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the coming part is your test. To test your prayer. We'll talk about it in the second part of the khutbah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. To test your prayer, to see you are doing the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the right way or not, very easy. Look at your prayer. Do you enjoy it? Are you waiting for your prayer? Are you feeling better when you pray? This means you have a good understanding to the meaning of love. And if you find the prayer is overwhelming or hard or having some issues or I might miss it or anything like that, that means you have a lack of understanding to the meaning of love. And I mean it, because what you are doing right now is the call of love. Allah is calling you to forgive your sins and mistakes. Allah is calling you, inviting you in a special invitation to remove your sins and your mistakes and your anxiety, depression, stress and everything. Allah is calling you to hear from you what you want. How come if I told you by the end of the street there is someone is waiting for you? He's willing to give you whatever you want in this life. Would you like that or not? Allah is calling you to give you what you want in this life and saving you from an eternal Jahannam and giving you an eternal Jannah. So how come we don't love enjoying standing before Allah and knowing when I'm finishing Assalamu alaikum, my sins and mistakes from last prayer to this prayer is forgiven. And all of my call and all of my dua is accepted. So you need to understand the meaning of love and who do you stand before that. Since I'm a teacher, I came to this country for da'wah 14 years ago with the command of my mother. And when I came here, I chose to be a teacher, to teach the little kids. I graduated from Al-Azhar University in Cairo, in Egypt. As you know, Al-Azhar University is like in Sharia and all of that. So my mother told me, it's forbidden. I feel guilty to keep you with me here. And I refused and rejected many times to come to this country because I want to stay with them. I'm the only son. And they're over 70 years and I don't want to leave. But she told me, you have to go to give the da'wah and to tell people about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when I came to this country, I was hesitating, imam or a teacher, so I chose both. Teacher 4 days, or actually 5 days a week, and imam 1 day, which is the day of Jum'ah. To deliver the message and to tell you about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as you know, as a teacher, I have to give an assignment. So I will leave you with 2 assignments, and after that I will give you the most rewarded act of worship you can do in your life, inshallah. The first, or these 2 assignments regarding the most beloved deeds to Allah, never tell your kids, go pray, is the wrong command. This is the most beloved deeds to Allah, but never tell them, go pray. If you want to tell them to pray, as Allah commanded us in the Quran, you tell them another word, come to pray. huge difference between these two words. When you say go, I'm isolating you from me. But when I say come, come shows love in it. And this is a call of love. The prayer is a love. So till they understand the meaning of love. Second assignment, never pray alone. Because when you pray alone, you are losing a lot of barakah and a lot of reward. Even if you cannot come to the most beloved places to Allah, the masjid, at least make a rule in the house or in the work, I will not pray alone. Because when you have 17 rak'ah a day, and you are praying it by yourself, is counted for you is 17. But when you pray it with jama'ah, is more than 459 rak'ah a day. How many rak'ah a week? How many rak'ah a month? And so on. So we don't want to miss these two great things. Number one, never tell your kids, go pray, tell them come to pray. Even psychologically, is good for them. Number two, don't pray alone. And as I promised you, I will end my khutbah with the most rewarded act of worship in the Quran. Allah has mentioned it in Surah Al-Munafiqun. The last three verses of this surah, Al-Munafiqun means the hypocrites. The surah is talking about the hypocrites. But the last three verses of this surah is talking about whoever applies them, is talking to the believer. Whoever applies them is not among the hypocrites. So I will go from the second last of this ayat, inshallah, because like we are running out of time. Allah is saying the most and the regret of the believer in the Quran. The regret means they are going to be in Jannah, but they don't want any level in Jannah. They want the highest level of Jannah. So Allah is talking about them in this ayah, and He's saying,
وَأَنفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُم مِّن قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين.
Allah is saying, give from whatever Allah has given you before the time of your death comes. And you will say, Ya Allah, if you delayed my death for a short period of time, what is the only action you are going to do? فَأَصَّدَّقَ فَاءِ الْعَرَبِي means right away, the only action I'm going to do. If Allah give me life back to come to this life, is only one action, to give sadaqah. Why? Why sadaqah is the most rewarded act of worship in the Quran? وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ to reach to the level of salihin. Salihin is the level of the prophets. As they are asking Allah in the Quran, وَأَدْخِلْنِي بِرَحْمَتِكَ فِي عِبَادِكَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Oh Allah, this is the dua of the prophets. Make me, Ya Allah, by your mercy among the salihin. Why? Because this is the highest level of Jannah, is the level of salihin. So you have all of you the chance of giving a unique kind of sadaqah and zakah, by the way, too. Serving the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that book. As I told you, I choose to be Friday is Imam, but the rest of the days I'm a teacher. So Fridays I go for da'wah and tell people about Allah and giving that Quran for non-Muslim and even for the Muslim to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are the only organization in the United States, Al-Furqan, as you know, giving that Quran to all da'wah organization free. And we have more than 40 teams of da'wah on the streets every week. And we give da'wah in the hospital, prisons, universities, campuses, and all, and even in the stores, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. So you can be our partner in da'wah. And this is, by the way, an obligation. It's not even a sunnah. That's an obligation upon us. We are living in this country to deliver and convey and help people to know who is Allah, especially in whatever going on in Gaza. That's as you can hear and see every single day, a lot of people entering Islam just by knowing who are those Muslims. And alhamdulillah, we in the last few months, we distributed more than 1 million copy of this Quran. And we are waiting for another 1 million copy to come, inshallah, and to distribute it to all over. It's not enough, I know, for 300 million people here. But we make our best, and because of your sponsorship of this Quran, so you can make your sadaqah in the Quran, inshallah. The one box of the Quran, 52 copies, by $104. And you can do your best, inshallah, in your way. But don't forget when you are doing that sadaqah, Don't forget to make an intention on the righteousness of my spouse or my kids or on behalf of your father, your mother, on behalf of the people in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the curb and inshallah to give them the freedom and to give them victory inshallah. Make many intention when you are doing that sadaqah and don't leave without doing that sponsoring. And this is an obligation, as I mentioned, as everyone should be sponsoring something inshallah. May Allah accept it from you. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا إني داع فأمنوا. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل عليه في الآخرين وصل عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. يا رحمن يا رحيم يا غياث المستغيثين. اللهم يا رب أغث أهلنا في غزة وفلسطين والسودان وإدلب واليمن وكشمير. اللهم يا رب انصرهم على من عاداهم. اللهم يا رب كلهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم أمدهم بمدد من عندك. اللهم يا رب أيدهم بجندك. اللهم يا رب كلهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم انصرهم على القوم الكافرين. اللهم انصرهم على المعتدين. اللهم يا رب تقبل شهيدهم وداوي جريحهم واشف مريضهم واجبر كثيرهم واربط على قلوب أهليهم وذويهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم تولى أمرهم. اللهم تولى أمرهم. اللهم تولى أمرهم. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة.